नमस्कार, आई एम डॉक्टर प्रियंका सूर्यवंशी, वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ होम साइंस एट ख्वाजा मोइनुद्दीन चिश्ती लैंग्वेज यूनिवर्सिटी. सो इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी वर डिस्कसिंग एरिक्सन थियोरी एंड ऑल द 8 स्टेजेस ऑफ एरिक्सन. सो वी रीच टू द स्टेज आइडेंटिटी वर्सेज कन्फ्यूजन दैट वॉज रिलेटेड टू एडोलेसेंस, एंड इन दिस लेक्चर विल बी मूविंग फर्दर टू द नेक्स्ट स्टेज. So the next stage is intimacy versus isolation, and it is related to young adulthood. If we talk about young adulthood, the main characteristic of young adulthood is that in this phase intimacy starts developing, either in your personal relationships or in the workplace where the person is working. So this is very important that openness to other is developed in this phase. So if the person is open to others, then we have intimate relationships in our personal lives, and also it could be friendship or in the workplace, working in a team or with your bosses. So all that happens smoothly. And in case the above stages resolutions did not happen properly or negatively, then that results into isolation. Such adults feel isolated in their environment. So the action is openness to others. If it is positively resolved, commitment to partnership and ethics to abide by the commitments happens. And in case it is negatively resolved, then self-absorbed identity too fragile to maintain uncertainties in relationship is the result. Moving to the next stage, that is generativity versus stagnation, that is middle adulthood. By generativity we mean giving something to the next generation. So if above phases have been healthy and positively resolved, and then at this stage in middle adulthood, generally people show generativity in the form of giving to your younger generations. For example, if the adult is involved in parenting, they would do a nice parenting that would result into good citizens. And if they are in workplace, they would produce something creative that would add on to the society. And in case above phases have not been resolved positively, then that would result in stagnation, and such personalities do not contribute anything to the society. So the action is concern for next generation. Positive resolution is concern for creation of better world, focus on service to others. And the negative resolution is lack long-term goals, live for short-term gratifications, and they generally do not contribute much to the society. Now coming to the last stage, that is integrity versus despair, and this is the last phase which Erikson has discussed, which is related to elderly phase or old age. If the development have been and the resolutions have been positive in all the above phases, then coming to the end phase of life, a person feels satisfied seeing his life journey. And in case above resolutions have not been positive, then the person has negative feelings like despair, fear of death, and they feel unfulfilled from the life that they have led. So the action is acceptance of one's life, and positive resolution of it is feel their lives have meaning and significance, and the negative resolution is view life as filled with missed opportunities. So these were the 8 stages that Erikson has discussed from the social perspective of development. And basically he has told that right from the birth till end phase of life, how identity and self-concept, development of identity and self-concept takes place in the human being. Thank you.